ਹਣਾ ਬਰਾਨੇ ਨਾ ਤੇ ਉਹਾਟ ਉਹ ਇਹ ਮੇਵਾ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਤੇ
ਹੈ ਗਾ ਮੈਂ ਕਿ ਰਹਿ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਰਤੀ ਰਹਿ ਨਹੀਂ ਤੇ ਹਿੰਦ ਪੂਰਾ ਕਪਾ ਮੇਰੀ ਕਹਾਣੀ ਦੁਬਾਰਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਉੱਤੇ ਰੱਖ ਦੂੰਗਾ Good evening, students.
Good evening, sir.
After some time, we are meeting because we had a lot of issues in registration. So we had to wait until everybody get on board. Right? So last time, there was a hasty decision from the university to conduct day schools, and we also had to adhere to that decision. And I think some of you might have lost that first 2 days schools. It's all right. All the videos are uploaded to that YouTube channel, and I'm going to upload them to your Learn or USL as well. So shall we wait a little bit, because still only 83 persons has come in. We are supposed to have more than 200 students. So I'm thinking of conducting day schools at this time. Do you think that it is a good time to conduct day schools? Because I feel like most of the working students find it difficult to admit to day schools during daytime. So that is why I decided to conduct these things in the evening, since we have the facility to do so.
Yes, sir. This time is good.
So I don't think there won't be any day schools at this time. So we can have regular classes, like more than 5 day schools. So because usually we are supposed to do five day schools for your school, for your course, but it is impossible to cover in 5 day schools. So what we did was summary lectures. This time we'll try to do a little bit more. So, as a wrap up, we did last time about the curves, right? horizontal, mainly the horizontal curves, right? So you will have to go through the books. And I think I have uploaded the block one for Learn OUSL. Normally we don't give the soft copies for students, but this time we have decided to do so because some of you might have not received the block one or the book one of this course. So we decided to upload some of these books to your Learn OUSL. Please download all the materials in Learn OUSL, which you will use frequently, and which is the new LMS for you to conduct the course on OpenUCT. So please download the block one if you don't have it with you from that resources, which I have put in the Learn OUSL. Then today we will start with use of vertical curves, right? Now we were talking about vertical curves, and we were talking about horizontal curves, and some of these curves I think I have explained to you in the last lecture. So basically, when it comes to vertical curves, there are two types of curves, summit curves and valley curves. You can go through your lecture note for further details. So you can see when the two lines of gradients intersect, as you can see in this picture, we have to provide a curve in the vertical plane to connect them, which is a vertical curve. So there are still some students are coming. Please come on time, right? We can't keep on admitting you to the system because it will disturb others. for example, if you want to create a connection between these two lines, we need to generate a curve here. Right. In order to generate a curve here, we need to have a scientific method to do so, so that the transition will be smooth. You all have experienced this on roads. I'm quite sure most of you have experienced vertical curves in the in the roads when you are traveling. Right. So when the gradient is moving from plus to minus, we call it the summit curve. But when the gradient is moving from minus to plus, we call it a sag curve. This is a simple thing. Normally, this is defined as with the definition of grade angle here. Now, grade angle is defined as G1 minus G2. G1 represents the approach gradient. G2 represents the decreasing or leaving gradient, right? So if A is plus, so it's a crest curve or a summit curve. If A is negative, it is a sag curve. So first, we need to have some mathematical relationship developed in order to plot these curves or to establish these curves in the field. So to do that, one second, please. to do that, we use a parabola, right? I mean, I'm quite sure you are used to these quadratic equations, which you have studied during A-levels and even during advanced maths you have learned in the OUSL course. Then let us consider a parabolic vertical summit curve, ABD, as shown in this figure, connecting a rising gradient. You can see this this part, the gradient is rising. So the gradient is positive. And in this part, the gradient is negative, right? So it is decreasing to a falling grade, CB. If we take the first... Could you please switch off your mics? I get your personal dialogues into the lesson. Please switch off your mics. See, switch off your mics. So for this parabolic equation, y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. I think number 7110705 07. Could you please switch off your mic, please?
It is
the class. I had to mute by voice. It's okay, right. Let's say this equation y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, so if you make the derivative, first derivative in this equation, it dy over dx becomes 2ax plus b. Using boundary conditions, now if you consider the boundary conditions at a and b here, at a, x is equals to 0 and y is also equals to 0. So at that point, the gradient of the curve is almost the gradient of the straight tangent here, g plus g1, right? So dy over dx equals g1 over 100. Then point B, when x equals capital L, dy over dx becomes minus g2 over 100, right? So by applying these two conditions, you can find out the constants A, B. So A and B becomes, you can work out the mathematics by yourself, because you have to be conversant enough in mathematics to do this kind of stuff. So A becomes minus G1 plus G2 over 200L, because if you have substitute this condition somewhere here, so you get B. If you substitute this condition, you will get A. So you know A, B, C now. So you can simplify this equation by substituting A and B, and you can get the equation for Y as shown here, which is equals to minus this whole thing, right? Right. now we are still in that continuation. If y dash is the depth from the tangent ACH, let's say at the point XY, let's say y dash is the depth from the tangent here, we can derive an equation for this as well, because if this is x, the height here is g1 over 100 into x, because this is the gradient, multiplication of gradient by x, you will get this height. And if you just deduct capital Y, you will get y dash. I think you have derived the previous equation here for y, so you only have to submit that equation for this y, right? So you will end up with this equation for y dash. Therefore, HB is this length, right? Here. HB is y dash L. Normally, when x is equals to L, this y dash will give you HB, because this represents the depth from the tangent to the curve, right? So it becomes this equation. And also you can get HB by adding J to JB, and you will have these two equations. So if you consider the two derivatives that you have derived for HB here and HB here, so they has to be the same. So comparing the two expressions, you can come up with this equation for CJ. So you can, from this equation, you can find out that CJ is equals to L over 2, right? CJ means this segment, right? Intersection. From intersection to the chain edge of the outer edge of the vertical curve, right? It becomes L over 2. And hence AF, what is AF? From A to F also becomes L by 2, because if this is L by 2, the whole thing is L. So you only have to deduct AG by CJ, then you will get L by 2 here. This means that the curve is of equal length on either side of the intersection point. This is the intersection point. So the curve, this curve is split into equal lengths. The latecomers, please come on time next time, otherwise you will miss some of the lessons. So we can further derive several equations. Now, if you consider at this intersection point, the height DE, which is the height from the crescent to the chord here, that is given by this equation here, right? And EF here is normally given by this height divided by 2, because if you consider these two triangles, this is half the size of this height, right? So with that, you can end up with an equation of ES as G1 minus G2 L by 100. Therefore, DE, which is DE here, is equals to DF minus EF here, right? DF minus EF here. So you only have to substitute these two values here, right? So when you substitute that, you will end up with this equation, DE equals G1 plus G2 into L by 800. Since Y dash equals this equation, I think we have derived it before for this Y dash, right? Now, CD also we can get when X equals L by 2, right? So Y dash at L by 2 equals, you only have to substitute L by 2 here. So you will end up with the same equation as of DE. So CD equals DE. So what it concludes is that the curve therefore bisects CE. So if you think about this line here from C to E, that line has been bisected by this curve at D. But in reality, all these lengths are almost similar, like AEB, this angular length is almost similar to AFG, because we are talking in the gradients of 1 to 5%, right? So these are very small angles if you convert them into tan values. So basically, this EF height is negligible. So therefore, this equation for Y can be written as this. So at mid offset of CD, where X equals L over 2 becomes Y, and Y becomes this equation where we have to submit L by 2 here, because this becomes 0, because since EF is negligible, this becomes Y equals G1 plus G2 over 200L into L by 2 squared. Therefore, Y dash over Y. Now, if you remember, Y dash equation is here, previously derived, right? So if you just put these two substitutions here, it will become an equation like this. Y dash over Y equals X squared over L by 2 squared, right? The mid offset Y was previously derived as G1 plus G2 over L by 800. So if you just substitute this Y value here, this capital Y becomes AL over 800. Remember, this is a very important derivation, right? Capital Y here at the middle, this height becomes AL over 800. What is A? Where A is the algebraic difference between gradients. So that is the algebraic difference between these two gradients into curve length. Now this is the curve from ADB, and L is the curve length divided by 800. Now we are slowly moving into vertical curve designs. And I'm all still admitting people. The latecomers, please come on time next time. Okay. So now we are moving into vertical curve design, right? Now that is the page 36 in your book, right? Now I have extracted all these things from your book, and I have tried to shorten it for you for your convenience. Right, but you need really need to go through the book and derive all these equations by yourself. Now, in order to design the vertical curves, need to obtain the levels along the chain edge. Right. Now, I believe you are conversant with the word chain edge because you have done surveying one. So when you are measuring the distance along the center line, we call it the chain edge, right? So you need to obtain the levels of the vertical curve along the chain edge. To obtain the levels, we need to know the length of the curve. To obtain the levels, we need to know the length of the curve. One minute, please. Sorry for the disturbance. I think we were here. Can you hear me? We were here. So to obtain the levels, we need to know the length of the curve, right? So without knowing the length of the curve and the curvature and the gradient differences, it is very difficult to establish the curve, right? So now, in order to establish the curve, first we have to determine the length of the curve, right? Then after that, I'm quite sure you have studied several methods in the last lesson. How to establish a curve with the help of the tangent and chord and various techniques. So normally we use establish it with the help of the tangent, right? So factors for length of the curve. Actually, there are three factors which determines the length of the curve. The centrifugal effect, daytime visibility, and nighttime visibility or headlamp visibility, we call it. Now, what is centrifugal effect? Now, when you are moving on a vertical curve, if you move really fast, you will feel like you are taking off yourself from the ground, right? This happens for many, you know, racing cars. I think you have seen it, right? When they take vertical curves, it flies off the ground. This is also centrifugal effect. I'm quite sure you have experienced this effect on roads when you are taking horizontal bends, right? So similarly, when you take vertical curves, the centrifugal effect comes into the equation. So two tangent points is equal to 2r sine delta over 2. Where did we derive this? I think we derived this in the previous lecture, and it is there in the page. The exact page. If you go through our previous slides, you will see that is figure 1.1. Which in that figure, we have derived this two tangent points is equal to the distance between two tangent points is equals to r 2r sine delta over 2, where r is the radius and delta is the deflection angle, right? The angle between two gradients. In vertical curves, we may approximate the length of the long chord to the length of the curve. So in the length of the long chord, in the vertical curve design, we assume it to be the length of the curve. I will show you that figure again. It is there in our previous presentation. Can you see this figure? Can you see? I think you can see, right? So now in this figure, we have derived this equation 2r sine delta over 2, right? And the induced angle is the angle difference between two gradients, right? Two gradients, right? G1 and G2, and this angle is created by that. Okay, that is the induced angle. Okay. And we may approximate the length of the long chord to be length of the curve L and deflection angle delta to grade A, right? So now you can simply take it as A for delta, which we have just discussed what is A in the previous slides, right? You can mathematically understand this, since delta over 2 equals delta over 2. Why? What is the reason for this? I am quite sure you should know the mathematics. Now, for small angles, now we can use the size of the angle itself, because we are considering very small changes, not very big changes. So, in under such circumstances, in radian, we can say like delta over 2 equals A over 200, because delta equals to A over 100. So this becomes A over 200. Therefore, L equals 2R sine delta over 2 becomes RA into 100. If the radial vertical acceleration, which is while negotiating the vertical curve, is F. Now, this is the centrifugal force, right? This is the equation for centrifugal force. If the velocity along the tangent at particular location is V and the curvature is 1 upon R, so we can write the vertical acceleration or radial acceleration as F equals V squared over R. So we can substitute this value here, right? Substituting for R, you can take the value for R as V squared over F, and we can substitute this value in this equation. So it becomes L equals A over 100 into V squared over F. The limit for F is normally given as 0.3 meters per second squared. That is the comfort limit, actually, right? If it is go above that, sometimes vehicle will fly and people will fly from their seats. So that is why this limit of acceleration is defined. So if we do the unit conversion, normally the speed of vehicles is given in kilometers per hour. Now these equations are derived, you can see V is in meters per second. So when we apply the unit conversion, this equation becomes L equals to A V squared over 1300 F. Now, there is another way of calculating this thing. You know, we cannot keep on calculating for different design speeds as of this equation, because when we design roads, I'm quite sure in highway engineering, you have studied transportation engineering, there are design speeds for roads, right? Now, for different design speeds, these K values are given. So normally this L is equals to K dot A. A is the angle difference, right? So for different angle differences, you can see the stopping side distance for different speeds, then passing side distance for different speeds. Then K values are also given in this table. So from this table, you can simply calculate the required curve length to satisfy the centrifugal effect. This is only to satisfy the centrifugal effect. Okay. Because don't misunderstand this with the other conditions, which is required to determine the length of the curve. You can see there are three conditions here: centrifugal effect, daytime visibility, then nighttime visibility or headlamp visibility, we call it. Now, we continue on this vertical curve design. Now, in daytime visibility, the daytime visibility depends on two factors. The safe stopping sight distance and the safe passing sight distance. And you can see, if a vehicle is coming in this direction, the driver here should be able to see the bottom of the preceded vehicle. So in order to satisfy this, depends on the design speeds, there are limitations of stopping side distance. Now, for these different stopping side distances, they'll have to see whether this minimum safe stopping side distance can be maintained on a curve. Then this figure shows the overtaking or passing or safe passing side distance. You see, they need to have a safe passing distance, otherwise this will collide with the other vehicle. So you will have to apply relative velocity here and you have to find out the safe passing distance. Two design conditions to determine the minimum length of summit curves, right? Now, based on these concepts, safe stopping side distance and safe passing side distance, we have designed two design conditions. The one is where the side distance S, this S, is less than the length of the curve. The other one is where side distance S is greater than the length of the curve L. We'll talk about the first case. So, I have shortened the notes. You will have to go through the block one, which I have uploaded to Learn OESL. I think some of you may have already purchased it. This is actually the figure 2.11 in your block one, right? 2.11 in your block one. Now, this simple edge represents the eyesight of the driver. Simple H2 represents the height of the obstacle on the other side here, right? Now, you can see this is upside down parabola, and in reality the parabola is like this downwards. So if you consider the height at length of L1, let's say, let's call it H1, we can simply substitute L1 to X, you can get H1 here, H1 as C into L1 squared. If we assume the curve, parabolic curve for this vertical curve as Y equals C into X squared. Similarly, for H2 here, because this has to be in straight line, because this is the side distance, right? And if you remember the previous one, you can see this is the side distance, right? Now, where C is a constant, right? Now, at L by 2, let's say the curve length is capital L. At L by 2, Y equals C L over 2. Then you can write, we can find C from this equation and can substitute into these two equations. And we can write this equation, right? Because here, we can simply write C as Y over L over 2 squared, right? So you can simply substitute that. So you can get this equation, right? And you can get the similar equation to H2 over Y as well. So you can derive further. And since the mid offset, Y equals AL over 800, I told you that this is a very important equation. We have derived this equation in this lesson previously. Y, this is at the mid offset. Now this is the chord, right? Now this is the mid offset, right? Y, which is equals to AL over 800, right? We had derived this previously, right? Now L1 squared, so you can substitute instead of Y in both of these equations, right? So you will end up with this equation, L1 like that. So the side distance S here can be obtained by L1 plus L2. So we can substitute from these two equations, we can derive this equation. Finally, we will end up with this set of equations. L equals S squared A over 200 into within bracket square root of H1 plus square root of H2, whole thing to square, bracket close, right? But when the curve is symmetric, let's say, and curve, let's say the height of H1 and H2 is similar, this equation will be simplified to L equals S squared A over 800H. Now further, we can simplify this equation by substituting D1 as square root of H1 and D2 as square root of H2. So this will be simplified into this equation to S equals L plus 200 over A into D2 plus D1 squared, right? You have to work out the mathematics, this is simple mathematics, right? There's nothing else. Therefore, length of curve here, you can derive the length of the curve as S2, because here 2S is here. You can take this to the other side and you can have this equation here, right? When H1 and H2 are equal, this equation is further simplified into this equation. When side distance is equal to the length of the curve, now this is a unique case where S equals L. The equation for either situation will give the correct value, right? L equals this equation, right? What are the two either situations? One is side distance is short. Other one is the side distance is longer than the length of the curve, right? If it is not known whether S or L is greater, we consider both cases, and it will be seen that one of them will not fulfill the appropriate argument is less than L or is greater than L. This will then be rejected. Now, there is a very nice example for this in your book. Now, that is SAQ 5, page number 41. Right? You can work it out and it will give the insight to this logic. It is very simply explained, right? You will have to work out this example SAQ 5 on page 41. Okay? Then we will come to the third condition, which is the headlamp visibility. Headlamp visibility. Now, these are two images from your book. One is 2.13 and other one is figure 2.14. Now, in this case, you can see the car is here and the headlamp is lit here and the headlamp visibility is S. If the headlamp visibility is less than the length of the curve, so you can derive equation similarly, right? And you can take BC here as K into S squared, right? This is again the same parabolic concept, right? Now, T 2D can be taken as, because this is the length offset from the tangent, right? These things are derived in the previous day school, KL squared, right? Hence, BC equals S squared or L squared by dividing these two equations. So you can derive several set of equations. Now, finally, you can derive an equation for BC here. BC equals to S squared over A over 200L. BC is also equals to H plus S into tan X naught. Now, if you take this BC here, right? If you consider this triangle here, now this is, this angle, the headlamp angle, let's say X naught, maybe around 1 degree, right? This is equals to H. This is the headlamp height H. Sorry. Headlamp height H plus this height. This height is S into tan X naught, this height. So if you add this, this height here, S into tan X naught plus H, which is also equals to BC. So by, you can simply equate this S squared A over 200L and you can derive these equations here. Let's say if X naught equals 1 degree, I think those who have cars knows that the angle of headlamps can be altered in some cars. So you know the kind of angle that you can alter. Let's say X naught equals 1 degree and H equals 0.75 meters. That is the normal standard height for headlamp, right? If you substitute that value, this equation will be further simplified. When the side distance is greater than the length of the curve, that is according to this figure, S greater than L, this entire length BC over IC, you can see I here, right? That is the intersection point. From IC, BC over IC equals A, right? That is the difference between two gradients, G1 and G2. And you can derive IC by simply deducting S by L by 2, because from this tangent point to the intersection point, it is L by 2. So if you deduct S from L by 2, it becomes IC. So you can substitute that, you will end up with this equation. So BC is also equals to H plus S tan X naught as in the previous case. So by substituting, you can simplify it further into this equation here. When S equals L, both expressions will give the same value for the length of curve. So that is the end of today's lesson, right? I think I took nearly 1 hour to finish it. But I didn't do any examples for you. Please go through example section 2.10, which is given the computation and setting out order. And there is a very nice example, and it is very simplified. It's a very simple version. I think it is from measuring from long cord, right? Now I'm thinking of continuing day schools in maybe what about this Saturday? Do you have any classes on Saturday, maybe around this time? Yes, you can speak. Do you have any classes on this Saturday?
No, sir.
Maybe around this time, I don't think there are any day schools scheduled. Right? And it is a lockdown, I think, on Saturday. So most of you are at home. Is that so? So we can... So I'll try to do a day school again on Saturday. So I'll try to move into tunnel service. And please work out yourself. You can see a lot of derivations are there based on mathematics. I think this is one of the best books in Sri Lanka. Right? There are many good textbooks available on surveying, but this is a very simplified book. Many people love this book, right? And please go through derivations by yourself, otherwise you will never understand the fundamentals. You know, I tried my best to teach you these equations without having a whiteboard, but I usually write all these things in the whiteboard and explain. Unfortunately, I can only deliver 60% of teaching of what I do normally in teaching. Sorry for that. You can ask any questions if you have. I want to have a discussion with you. You can ask, or even you can chat, right? If you are shy to ask. Do you have any questions? Yes.
Good evening, sir. Sir, I'm a student who registered as a interim curricular student, but unfortunately, I won't be able to finish my degree in the relevant time given by the university. So I had to shift to the revised curriculum, the new curriculum. So, yes. But I got eligible this subject previous year, and I only have to face the final exam. So it is allowable to write final exam under CVX.
Yes. It will be this. There will be only one paper, right? So you will be eligible to write the CVX 5.4.40, no issue, right? And But unfortunately, there is a credit issue. Now, if you pass in the previous syllabus, you will get 5 credits because it was considered as 5530, if you remember. So it has 5 credits.
Yes,
but in this syllabus, unfortunately, due to balancing, some sort of balancing in credits for the syllabus, 1 credit has gone missing. So you will only get 4 credits. So now these sort of issues are there when the syllabuses are changing. So my advice is for you to finish your degree as soon as possible. We don't know what will happen in another 2 or 3 years time. Okay. Sometimes there might be another curriculum revision after IESL recognition process. We don't know, right? So when curriculum changes in Open University, it is a hectic thing. It is a real trouble for the students, and it's a real pain for lecturers as well, right? So my advice for you is to finish your work. Don't hang around. Please study, right? You have very nice books. We never had such notes when we were undergraduates, right? Please study yourself, okay?
Okay, sir, okay. Okay, thank you very much.
Good evening, sir.
Yes.
Sir, my name is not included in the survey group, the camp group. So what should I do for that?
Are you a first timer?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry, we will generate the list again. Now, the matter is this. Now, this time everything was jumbled in the Open University. They were teaching while registrations were going on. Even though we completed the registration, the Colombo CRC had to enter your stats into the list. So I thought by 8th of April, we were supposed to finish registration. So I asked IT to generate the list on 8th of April. But unfortunately, even after that, your names were entered late into the system, right? So don't worry, I'll be generating the list again. Now, I mean, it's a faraway story now. Survey camp. I don't know whether it's a faraway story, right? So actually, I plan to conduct the survey camp in August. August 1st to 13th. I hardly believe that we will be able to conduct the survey camp at that pre-planned durations because of this present pandemic situation. Right? So don't worry. We are going to generate the list again, right? In that list, if you don't have your name, please contact me. No issue, right?
Okay. Thank you.
So I have a doubt which is not relevant to the subject today, which is something relevant to the administration. So I don't have access to the OUSL eLearn. I even tried to go to the KRC and try to solve my problems, but due to the pandemic and stuff, I couldn't go there.
Is there
something I could do with online or by over the phone or something like that?
Did you try to contact the department head? Actually, I'm using his account to teach you.
No, sir, not yet.
Please email him, right? He will direct you to some sort of person who can help you. I don't know who did this Learn OUSL. Actually, we had another LMS called eLearn last year, right? I mean, if there are any repeat students who are doing this time, you know that I communicated through eLearn last time. Now that entire platform is no longer there, right? I mean, there is a limit that we also can do for you, but anyway, we'll do our best for you, right? Please contact the department head, right? Unfortunately, okay, I can understand your situation. Now, you are Abdul Rahman, right?
Okay. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Do you have my email?
I think I can get it from my fellow mates in the WhatsApp group, sir.
Yeah.
Send
an email to me. Send to email to my official email, GNPAR. I'll chat, right? This is my official email, GNPAR@ou.ac.lk. Please send an email to this one, right? So okay, what sir. I will do, if you send, I will try to send the files personally to you, right? Some, I don't know, I can't do it for all the students. I can understand that, right?
Yes.
So, whatever the things, maybe, do you have block one with you?
So I didn't even receive books or anything like that, sir. I think
nobody receives it. You have to take it from the regional centers. Did you go and take
I belong to Kandy Regional Center, sir.
Did you check it at Kandy Regional Center whether this book is available or not? Survey into block one.
So I didn't go there because I order it to, you know, by postal stuff. There was something going on like that, no, sir. So
I didn't deliver. So don't wait. Yeah. You go and inquire from the KRC. I think KRC open tomorrow. Right?
Okay, sir.
I don't know whether it is functioning or not. I don't know. Don't wait. I mean, the entire open university has become a mess because of this pandemic. Nobody knows who is doing what. Right? And okay, I mean, we had a huge trouble of you people making graduates for last 1.5 months. Finally, we made the list, the graduation list now. I think around 78 graduates this time from our department. Right?
Okay,
so you have to be proactive for yourself, right?
Yeah, sir.
I'm warning you, right?
Okay, so sir. Thank you, sir.
You send an email, I'll send this to you, right?
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you.
Means a lot. Any more questions? Still, people are coming so late, right? See? Are there any questions? I will upload this video to Learn OUSL as well as to the YouTube channel, right? You know my YouTube channel, I think most of you know. For those who do not know the YouTube channel, this is the YouTube channel. Somebody is asking about CAT 1. Normally, the CAT 1 is comprised of this block 1. So we had to finish until the triangulation, right? So that is why I'm thinking of putting more day schools and finishing it off. I was a little reluctant to put the thing because the registrations were going on. I don't know how many students will be there. Some students will miss lessons. That is why I didn't put any classes. Now I am going to do more classes. Like once in a week, I will do a class. So with that, we will able to finish this before the CAT 1, right? At the moment, there are some discussions going on to conduct CAT 1 online. Still, it is not finalized. Once it is finalized, they will let you know. Now, somebody is asking about past papers. We are not good in answering questions on paper, sir. So that I can't help. Right? I'll try to do few problems, but I'm not a fan of these past papers because, this is the second time I am conducting this course. I'll definitely not look into past papers when I'm going to make a question paper. I always make a brand new question paper. So I always advise you to gather knowledge, practice your book and come to the exam. Don't wait until last moment. I know many people do this at Open University because many of you study this degree as an external degree. That is totally wrong. Your attitude is totally wrong if you consider this degree as an external degree. This is an open and distance learning degree, but it doesn't mean that it is an external or a part-time degree. This is a full-time degree. If you are doing a subject, please try to dedicate few hours per week at least. If you can dedicate 1 hour per day, it is better. But at least try to dedicate few hours per week to study by yourself. We expect you to say study the same content as of a internal conventional graduate, right? Because when you pass out from this university, from our department, you are considered as an equivalent to conventional engineering graduate, right? So don't take this lightly, and we will not pass you for, you know, for merits. Okay, we will always pass you for your performance. Remember that very well, right? So please, I know last time many of you have made the same mistake. Please don't repeat that mistake. Please study from the very beginning. And if you go through my last question paper, I have asked mostly from the book. It is very sad that only 86 people were able to pass the subject. Out of 206, only 86 people passed the subject last time, around 41%, right? This is all because of your attitude towards your study, right? So that is my advice. I will try to do a few problems later, but that is not, it will not be targeted for the exam. Remember that, okay? Are there any questions? Now, somebody is asking about model questions. Now, CAT is a paper based on fundamental knowledge, right? CAT, we are going to check whether you understood the subject matter. Anyway, I will try to do one or two questions to give you an hint about the nature of questions. Please don't misguide by that, considering that the same type of questions will be asked at the CAT exams. I'll never do that. I am not a lecturer who camouflage things for you. I don't believe in that, because we are producing graduates with skills. You need, at the end of the study, you need to have certain skill level. Please understand that. Okay. I'll try to do few questions, but don't copy those questions as the kind of questions you will get in the CAT. Yeah, you're asking my phone number. You can always contact me on my email. I have given you my email address. Please go through the chat. I'll give you again. You can always communicate with me through this email, right? Don't worry. Somebody is asking to schedule day schools around 6 a.m. I don't think many people will like it, because I know some of you are working, and it is really troubling for those who are working to attend day schools early morning, because I know the hectic life you spend, that you live, right? Is there any hint of commencing the CAT run even via online? Yes, yes. They are planning. They will let you know, right? Now somebody is asking for YouTube. Please go through the chat. I think you can go through the chat, right? I have put the YouTube channel. My YouTube channel is GunnyTube. There is one GunnyTube.
So I think you have shared the email and the YouTube links to private.
Yes. I have done many times before. But I believe that there are some new students here. There are some new students.
We can't see the email in the chat, sir. I think you have shared it to someone privately.
Really? No. Yeah. To everyone. Wait. ENPR@ou.ac.lk. Can you see? I think you should be able to see everyone. No, I have shared it to everyone. Can you see?
No, sir, you can't see.
No, sir, not yet.
You know, it's in waiting room. Wait. Everyone in meeting with. One meeting. ENPR@ou.ac.lk. Can you see?
Yes, sir. Now we can see.
So the YouTube channel is this one. Can you see?
Yes.
Shall we have a class on Saturday? Saturday is, I believe it is 22nd, around 7:30. Shall we? Yeah. So I think this time is convenient for most of you, I believe. And I also like to admit those late attendants. I mean, even 3 or 4 students came after finishing the lesson today, right? Please come on time, right? It is disturbing others, it is disturbing me because I had to admit all of you here continuously, right? Please come on time, right? I will send the link and everything. There is there is another email we have established for this purpose initially. Do you have this email surveying OUSL 2021? Unfortunately, it is administered by our academic, the course coordinator. He is also on leave now. So, what shall I do? Those who do not have this this thing. Can you start around 8 p.m.? No problem. I can start around 8 p.m. Somebody is asking to turn off the waiting room. Okay, I will do it next time. Okay, I'll do it next time. So somebody is asking around 8 p.m. Is it okay, 8 p.m.? Is 8 p.m. okay for you?
Yes, sir.
For me, even 10 o'clock is okay, right? But, right. I can understand. Yes. So I'll start around 8 o'clock. I'll check whether this Learn Zoom allow me to do after 8. There is a time limitation for Learn Zoom. Anyway, I will start around that time, 8 o'clock. No problem. But please study then, right? Please go through this equation derivation. You study yourself, right? So. Please drop an email, those who do not have this Learn OUSL Act, to my email. I'll try to send this book to you. And also, please contact Dr. Karunanand. Those who do not have LearnOUSL access. Okay, then shall we wrap up the meeting today? I will upload the videos to YouTube channel as well as for the LearnOUSL. Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good night.
Thank you, sir.